Welcome to my wood shop. Yes, I am sacrificing fashion for safety. Michael Baggerly, if you're out there, you would be very proud of me. But I am going to take these off since I'm not doing anything that actually could harm my eyes. So, welcome to my wood shop. I'm out here tonight. I'm getting ready to do a show on September 10th at the Sunday Franklin Market at the factory in Franklin here. And so you're seeing a lot of my process. I'm in the studio, and now here's my workshop. This is my wood shop, and I've got a miter saw, a router, a brad gun, and a couple other pieces of equipment. I don't do much, but I do build my panels that I paint on. This panel behind me, it's hanging on the wall. This is my garage, and I have all kinds of panels that are in process that I'm working on, or my children are working on, or what have you, unfinished panels that I don't have room for, so I just put a nail on the wall and hang them up just to create more space and have room, but they're all unfinished things. But I do build my own wood panels. I also build frames for canvases for the copper trees that I was telling you about. And I make drop frames for my encaustic work, which I do on these little wood panels. Oh, that's upside down. And so I am right now, I have tons of pieces that I've finished that just need a frame around them. So that's what I'm doing tonight. But I thought I'd share with you a little bit of my process. Usually when I start, when I begin anything creative, which could be anything, it could be organizing my closet, it could be cooking dinner, it could be building a wood panel, it could be painting, it could be sewing, you name it, there's creative energy around it, right? I do try to do some rituals, not rituals, but more just markers of inviting God into the process. One of my favorite prayers, it's called the Amana Christi, I think is what it's called. And it's become a favorite prayer. And a lot of times I'll just begin by observing space, the space that I'm working in. And I will quietly just pray this prayer. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Hi, kitty. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Permit me not to be separated from thee. From the wicked foe, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me. And bid me come to thee, that with thy saints I may praise thee forever and ever. Amen. And just say, Jesus, be with me in this process. Let me feel your presence. So, I've cut these. Kitty, you cannot be here right now. She's mad. She likes to help me create. Anyway, I cut these. I get these long panels of wood, and with the router, I take my rabbit attachment and I route out this little lip right here. And this creates my drop frame. So I've got four of these. It's going to frame this piece. This is a photograph I took on the beach when I was visiting my mom and stepdad last spring, I think it was. And we went under this pier. And I got a photo of it, and so I mounted it on wood, and I'm putting it, I treated it with encaustic, and now I am putting it in this frame. So, got my wood glue. I'm just gonna miter these two corners together. And I'm gonna hit it with a couple of brad nails, and then just let it dry, and the other side. I've been thinking a lot about the idea of waiting lately, because I feel like every time that I have some time just to listen to the silence, like I've talked to you about this before, I feel like what I'm hearing there is wait and trust me for a lot of things in my life. There's a lot of transitions in my life right now. There's a lot of waiting. There's a lot of questions. All right, and I don't know if you can even see what I'm doing, but, and I should be wearing my safety glasses. Michael Baggerly, don't look. But, so this theme of waiting seems to be, and every time I go to the silence, I kind of have a wrestling match with God. Like, I know what you're going to say to me, that it's all in the waiting. And you know what? I know this. I've seen it before in my life. Like, I know it's true that God does something inexplicable in the waiting. And that even though it looks dormant, it looks like nothing is happening, I think that's where our trust has to come in, that there is something happening, but it's really not something that we're doing. It's something we're observing. We're watching. We're waiting. We're asked not to do anything. But our work in it is to wait and look, observe, and listen, and trust. All of those things require trust, because there's always something we can be doing, right? And the world tells us our efficiently run households and structures and all of, you know, government, church, all of these things that are efficiently run, efficiency talks and says that you should be doing something, or you could be doing something, and you should be doing something. Well, if we listen to the silence, we hear God saying the opposite of that. We hear Him saying, actually, I don't want you to do anything. I want you to wait. I want you to trust. I want you to lean. And listen to me. And be with me in that not doing. Which is really, really difficult for us. We're used to doing. We're doers. We're movers. We're shakers. We're told to be movers and shakers. And when God says something different, ouch, right? Surely there's something we can do. But I think that's a way that He can care for us. A way that we can actually rest and have a break from all the doing. And there's something so beautiful, magical. There's something so magical that happens if we can wait, step back, behold, and just observe what's happening. We're intaking. We're taking in what's present, what's real. I came out here into the wood shop a little bit ago and started cutting wood, and it brought me back to 4 years ago when I got my art degree, and I'm looking at all of these things. This is part of what observing and waiting and looking does for us. I'm looking at all this equipment. You know where this equipment came from? It came from a garage sale, one of my neighbors. I got all of this equipment, pretty much. A couple things I bought new, like the brad gun and the miter saw. But I got some really good deals on it, and the money came from generous, generous people who celebrated with me my graduation and gifted me money so that I could set up my home studio. That's where all of this came from people who care about me and love me, and showed that through generosity in that moment of time. And my hands are touching these things that people that loved me and that have been part of my life gifted me with. I don't know that I would have taken that in, that wouldn't have been part of my inventory, had I not been in a posture of, it's a time to wait, time to listen, time to observe. And with that comes the practice of gratitude. What is here? What is present? What is now? And what am I being asked to do? So there's something really beautiful that happens. And if you've ever had that experience, you know, after a season of waiting, you move into a season of movement, of flourishing. It's like all of the things that have been germinating in the dark start to come up through the surface, and you start to see all this beauty around you, this new life, this growth, this greenery that somehow you were aware of its presence but didn't know exactly what it was because it hadn't been revealed yet. And that's really what waiting asks of us, to trust that there is going to be greenery on the other side, and it's going to be beautiful, and there's going to be flourishing and life and beauty. So it's really important, but it's really important in those moments where you feel like you should be doing something or accomplishing things. Sometimes that's not what you're being asked to do. And there are needs all around us. The need does not necessitate the call. You know, we get asked to do things all the time. If we said yes to everything, you know, being the yes man, how crazy is that? We're not asked to say yes to everything. We're asked to let our no's be no and our yes be yes, and us to live inside of that with no regret, and it be okay. So that is my time for you tonight, and thanks for joining me. I'll see you next time.